I've obviously been skeptical about the whole COVID-19 government response since day one. And to be clear, I believe this is a virus. I believe there are people that died from this virus. I believe there are people infected. But I want to be clear as a physician, I believe the actions taken by our government are completely unfounded by any medical science whatsoever, and completely causing irreparable harm that far outweighs anything this virus can do. I've been very vocal about the delay of elective surgeries, the issues that are coinciding with social isolation, increased murders, increased suicide, the increased anxiety, depression, people with mental illness, and just all the things that are coming from these complete overreaction from the virus. I wanted to share some data that I've obtained. This is data from St. Tammany Parish. This is dated from March 14th to May 21st. And this is all the data for St. Tammany Parish in regards to number of cases, deaths, and so forth. I just want to give the highlights to show exactly what is going on, to kind of help separate some of the conspiracy theorists from the actual reality of this data. So just to give the numbers, ages of 30 to 39, 3 deaths, ages of 40 to 49, 3 deaths, ages of 50 to 59, 6 deaths, ages 60 to 69, 24 deaths, ages 70 to 79, 32 deaths, ages 80 to 89, 53 deaths, ages 90 to 99, 35 deaths. So just to make the math easy for you, for people over 80, it's 56% of all the deaths. If you go to patients over 70, it's 77% of all the deaths. And I want to take this to a step further. When you look at this data, majority of these patients are nursing home patients. They all have a host of medical comorbidities, hypertension, diabetes, lung disease, previous smoking history, obesity. The patients under 40, one of which was a 460-pound patient. So these are not people with just routine hypertension, routine diabetes. These are very sick, unstable patients. As a physician who's taking care of patients like this, it's hard to determine what these people die of. When someone has unstable diabetes, when they're in a nursing home, bed sores, emphysema, lung disease, all these things, it's impossible to say, well, the virus is what broke the camel's back. How is that possible? These people die all the time from just their medical problems, age-related, normal medical diseases. And if you happen to swab them and they test positive for COVID-19, now all of a sudden it is a COVID-19 death. In my mind, if you die from emphysema from smoking, you didn't die from emphysema, you died because you smoked your entire life. So we are completely shutting down our world, completely destroying future to our kids, and doing irreparable harm to our economy for these type of numbers. This is not medical founded logic. It is absolutely related to politics. It's absolutely related to government. I hate to sit here as a physician and get involved in politics, but open your eyes, people. This is not medicine. Let me share with you some real stories of what is really dangerous in our world. My cousin and one of my patients work in the oil field. They both told me the same story for two different companies. 6 months ago, they each had 350 employees in their company. Today, they're one of 16 employed in their company. That is insane. And that is all based on this. We are wearing masks, don't wear masks, social isolation, flattening the curve. This doctor saying this doctor saying that. What I have learned from all this is we have a complete lack of medical leadership in our country. I relate doctors that are giving information in terms of science. They're no different than the weatherman. You can be 50% wrong, you can be 70% wrong. It doesn't matter. All you gotta do is quote a study, and all of a sudden you become a thought leader or a healthcare hero fighting for this cause. Again, I'm not downplaying these deaths. I'm not saying these people didn't die. I'm not saying this virus isn't real. I'm not saying 80,000 people didn't die of the flu this year. I didn't see any healthcare hero campaigns. I didn't see any wear your mask campaigns. I wanna be on the record very clear. The steps that our government has taken against this virus is a complete and utter hoax. It is not real. It makes no scientific sense whatsoever. All of this data is being skewed. The numbers coming out of New York, the numbers coming out of Colorado, we are learning more and more every day that these COVID-19 deaths aren't real. I posted on social media, had a patient whose father died of a heart attack in his house, went down as a COVID-19 death. Had another nurse case manager who had a family member die of an automobile accident. went down as a COVID-19 death. You see these stories over and over and over and over again, but yet we continue to watch businesses such as Pier 1, JCPenney's, J. Crew, we'll never see movie theaters again. All of these industries with 40% unemployment, for what? What are we doing? This is not medicine. This is not about a virus. I urge my medical colleagues, stop lining up and giving validity to something that is absolutely insane. We are medical professionals. We are grounded in science. We deal with death, dying, and diseases all the time. How can we validate what the government is doing? It is absolutely insane, and we owe it to our patients, to the citizens. We owe it to the oath we took as physicians and nurses when we were in school to do no harm, to always do the right thing. We are doing harm by validating this illogic and leading to 40% unemployment, which we know is going to lead astronomical homicide, astronomical suicide. Our children who don't even have a voice in this are being taken out of school, are social distancing. It doesn't make sense, people. Open your eyes, the data is here. We now know this is an absolute hoax. This is not real. This has nothing to do with medicine. This has nothing to do with science. This has everything to do with politics and political agenda. Thank you.